Chelsea
and Kendra,
and today we're going to be sharing with you guys our Sephora VIB sale recommendations. Now I was gonna suggest that we include this in our haul, but I feel like the video will be way too long because y'all know our VIB sale haul is usually extremely long and very epic. Mm-hmm. So be on the lookout for that after our stuff comes in, because we ordered online. Mm-hmm. So we're just waiting on our stuff to come in. But we decided to split them in two separate videos. So today we're going to be sharing with you guys some of our recommendations. We just basically narrowed it down to the stuff that we've been using the most lately that's on Sephora. So yeah, we're not going to ramble too much. We're just going to quickly give you guys recommendations. So yeah, let's just go ahead and jump right into it.
So first we're going to start with makeup related items. So I'm just going to start with primers. And I don't feel like I've mentioned these in any favorites videos, but I find myself picking them up every time I do my makeup. But I don't know why I don't mention them in favorites. That's weird. Yeah. But Kelsey sees me use these all the time as well.
Yeah.
Before I start my makeup. So these are from the brand called J1. This is a Korean brand. And I feel like Korean beauty never steers me wrong. I have not tried one Korean product that I don't like. So these are both pretty much primers, but I feel like they're also in the skincare category because they're both very beneficial to the skin. So this is the first one that I ever tried from them. This is the J1 Jelly Pack, Dramatic Firming Skin with Improved Elasticity and Pore Smoothing. So this is a very tacky, jelly-like product. So this is what it looks like when it comes out. It's a very like sticky, tacky product, but when I tell y'all, it's so good for making your makeup stick like glue. Like, my makeup does not move when I use this, but this does not make my skin oily, because some primers that are meant for the benefits of your skin, like in combination, tend to make my face feel greasy. But this does not do that. I love how firm and tight my skin feels when using this. If you're like super young, you probably won't care, but I feel like the older I get, the more I love like firming and tightening things.
Yeah, it's true.
Like, everybody just want to feel snatched everywhere, you know?
Yeah.
So I love the way this feels on my skin. It evens everything out. I like that sticky, tacky feeling, because I feel like my makeup is going to cling better and it's not going to move around as much.
Yeah, it's true.
So I love this. Super good. So this is the first one I tried. And then a few months after, they came out with this one, which is the J1 Red Jelly Pack, and it says a true multitasker with antioxidants. It's a makeup primer, anti-aging serum, and it says anti-wrinkle. And this is made in Korea, of course, like that one. This is like this on steroids. Like, this is like this product. This is like the more simplified version of this, and this is like extra benefits.
Got it, with the antioxidants.
Yes.
Which is great for daytime because it helps fight against free radicals
and you know, the environmental aggressors.
Yes.
So I love this, and this has like a bit of a pink kind of jelly kind of color. It's very similar to the same, to the texture of the white one, but this one is a little bit more serum like. It's more smooth.
So this one is more sticky.
That one is more sticky. This one is like smoother. So I really like this for any time of year. I feel like that one is really good for the summer, which is perfect for this time of year. So if you guys are just looking for a summer primer, this is bomb. If you're looking for like an all-in-one kind of skincare product and a primer, and you're kind of lazy when it comes to skincare routine and prepping your skin for makeup, this is kind of like an all-in-one kind of thing. So I love this. I feel like I'll probably be taking this with me on like vacations this year. I'm obsessed with it, and it has not broken me out. So
this doesn't leave you oily even though it has extra like skincare?
No.
Okay.
I feel like my skin, this dries pretty quickly too, so when you work it in, you have to kind of work kind of fast. But this feels like it has hyaluronic acid in it, this one. So it's like a little bit lighter. This feels like a thicker, jelly, kind of sticky, tacky extra.
Like down to business.
Yes. This seems like a milder formula because of the extra stuff that's in it. So I feel like it kind of like made it a little thinner of consistency. That's just my take on it. Other people might think differently. But I love the both of these. So I highly recommend the J1 Jelly Pack products. Super good. And I have very oily to combination skin. Combination when it's colder and then oily in the summertime. Just all over. So these are
bomb. So the first makeup product that I have to recommend to you guys is something I mentioned in a favorites this past year. I think. Yeah, it was this past year. And it is the Cover FX Power Play Concealers. These are amazing. I raved about them in the favorites video. I'm absolutely obsessed with these. I love how full coverage they are, but they're very smooth and creamy without feeling tacky under the eye, because I feel like concealers that are a little bit thicker go on cakey and they're really hard to blend out to me. So I like these because they're buildable and you can just like keep packing some on and you still won't be cakey. So that's also why I like these. And the colors are so, so nice and neutral. I'm in the colors G Deep 2 and then P Deep 3. So both of these are really good colors. I like to mix them and sometimes I like to use one or the other. They're just very versatile and sometimes I just use these and put on some powder and I'm good to go. So they're really good coverage without feeling cakey. So I like that nice balance with my concealer. So I'm just obsessed with these. I also got the foundation for the haul, so I'm really excited to try those. But if I love the foundation as much as I love these concealers, then Cover FX is going to keep moving up on my makeup like favorites as far as like trying like more products from them, because I love their primers as well. So these concealers are the absolute truth. If you have not tried them, this is your time to try them during the sale.
And the concealer that I recommend to you guys the most that has stood out to me out of all the concealers that I've tried recently is this Fenty Beauty one. This is their Pro Filter. Yep, that's it. Pro Filter Instant Retouch Concealer. I love this. This is in the color 430. Mm-hmm. So this bomb. We really raved about the foundation as soon as that came out. Mm-hmm. And this is the perfect product to go with it. Like
combine, yeah.
To combine with it. Like they are married. They go together. So you might want to use them together. This is super thin of a formula. Kind of reminds me of the Kylie Cosmetics concealer.
Yeah,
which
is.
I also love. It's very watery, very thin. It doesn't feel cakey or like uncomfortable under the eye. Mm-hmm. And especially in the summertime, even though I hardly wear makeup in the summertime, to be quite honest. But when I want to do like a quick kind of like even like natural face, natural, my version of natural. That's when I say natural, I mean I'm not doing eyeshadow. So that's my version of it. Everyone has their own version of a natural makeup look. Mm-hmm. But this is like the perfect concealer for those kind of days when you just want to like slap on some concealer foundation, a very thin layer. Mm-hmm. So you can still feel, you know, breathable coverage. This is bomb for that. And they have so many color selections. Like you guys will find your perfect shade, whatever you're looking for. If you want to be brighter under the eye, if you want something similar to your skin tone, she has all those options. So I highly recommend this.
So my next recommendation is something that I've been recently loving. I was going to mention it in our April favorites, but I'm just going to go ahead and recommend it to you guys so you can go ahead and shop. Yeah, you might want to, yeah, get on this.
Yeah.
This is the new Fenty Beauty bronzers, and I'm in the color Coco Naughty. This bronzer is so bomb. I've already used it, so it's kind of dirty already, but I've already started using it. And I've been using it the past month and I'm obsessed with it. Like, it's very matte, so I like that it's not, like I love my Guerlain bronzer, but that is more of a winter bronzer because it's a moisturizing bronzer. And this to me is a nice year-round bronzer because it's matte and it's very buildable, so it doesn't go on too harsh. So you can keep going back in, tapping a little bit off and putting it on without it looking harsh. So that's also why I like it. It's super buildable. It's not chalky.
So it's blendable.
Very blendable, because that's one thing I don't like about some matte bronzers. They go on kind of chalky and make my skin feel super dry. Uh-huh. And that's kind of hard to do because I'm oily. Even though the older I get, I feel like I'm becoming more combination. Because uh-huh. some areas I've been getting a lot of dry patches, like around my mouth, which is weird. But this is the perfect balance. So I feel like if you have dry skin or oily skin or a combination, you would love this bronzer. This is like a universal bronzer. I feel like anybody would like it. So
she should have called it universal bronzer?
Isn't one of her other products called universal?
I think so.
I feel like she has that name on her other products. This bronzer is bomb. You have to get your hands on it. It's the reason everybody's talking about them because they're that amazing. And the packaging is like cherry on top of the delicious cake.
So pretty.
So pretty.
Okay, and the very last makeup product that I want to recommend to you guys is something that I feel like I'm going to forever use. Like forever. This is the Fenty Glow Gloss Balm, and this is the very first one she came out with. I know she has two other shades, like a white pearly one and then like a pinker one. This is more rosy. This is my favorite. This is the darkest one that she has. I'm obsessed with this one. This just says Fenty Glow. So this is the Fenty Glow one. I'm obsessed. It goes with every kind of lip combo I want to do. I feel like it makes every lip combo I put together even better. So this is just bomb. It does have little glitters in it, but you can't see it on your lips.
Or feel them.
If I had to pick like top five glosses, this is in there. Period. Without even thinking about it, like I throw this in my bag. I feel like I see girls who don't even really wear makeup use this.
Yeah.
Because it looks so good on everybody. Mm-hmm. So this is definitely like a universal product. You can check out her other shades if you're into, you know, lighter glosses. If you like more of a pearly, like a more metallic kind of lip. I feel like that pearl one might have that kind of look. But this is just enough for me. I don't need all that. Love this.
And then my last makeup recommendation is something that I've talked about before, but this is the translucent deep version. This is the Laura Mercier translucent powder. And if you're darker skin, I really feel like you would really enjoy the medium deep color, because sometimes you don't want that extra bright under eye, or you know, you just want something that's like more neutral looking. And I feel like this is perfect. So I really like using this to bake, or sometimes I'll just like put a little bit around my mouth to help with like the creasing. So this is just as good as the original. It's just a darker color. So it's absolutely amazing. I went ahead and got the big one because I went through the smaller one so fast. So I just had to get the big one. So this is definitely a must and a staple.
Okay, so on to non-makeup products. It was very hard to dwindle these down. I have two products left. I know that's
it's very hard.
That's kind of dramatic coming from me because I love products. Like, the next two categories I'm about to mention, I love body care and I love fragrance. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you should be proud of me. So, the first and only body product that I recommend to you guys, I just want to give you guys less options to have it more condensed down, because it's so easy to get carried away on Sephora during these sales and get way too much stuff like I normally get. But I just want to recommend like the best stuff that has stood out to me from the previous sales that I bought stuff from. And this is a product that I bought during the sale last year. And this is the Way Rose Hair and Body Oil. I only use this on my body. Have not tried it on my hair because I like her actual regular hair oil and her hair care line. I just like this just for my body. This is like the prettiest, softest, rosy scent oil. And it's very thin. If you're a person who's lazy about putting on lotion when you get out of the shower, because there are those people who don't like feel like putting on lotion. I used to be that person, and then I turned into the complete opposite, and now I'm like crazy about like moisturizing when I get out.
Yeah,
because I just feel like a squeezed sponge. Like I have alligator skin if I don't moisturize it.
Yeah.
So I'm crazy about body care. It seeps into your skin like so easy. It doesn't take forever to rub in like some lotions and body creams.
Yeah.
This is just super easy. It dries really fast. So if you don't like getting in the bed feeling really sticky or like goopy, because I know some body oils tend to do that. I don't mind that feeling because I feel like I'm being heavily moisturized, so I don't really mind. But if you don't really like that feeling, this is perfect. It's super lightweight, and I feel like it's perfect for summer because you're not going to be like hot. Because I know sometimes when you have like moisturizer on, like even in the daytime, it makes you sweat more. But this is super thin, so I feel like everybody would love this. It's bomb, and the smell isn't too overpowering if you want to wear perfume, so it's bomb.
Okay, so since we're on the topic of oils, I'll just mention these two cleansing oils to you guys that I like to use to remove my makeup, because I use makeup wipes sometimes, but I'm more of a like cleansing oil type of girl because I feel like it's faster and more gentle on my skin. Because I feel like with wipes, I find myself wiping too much. And if you use wipes, you leaving a lot of makeup behind, I'm just telling you. So these are the two that I've been obsessed with. This is a newer favorite. I'll go ahead and start with this one. This is by Kiehl's. This is their Midnight Recovery Botanical Cleansing Oil with Squalane, Evening Primrose Oil, and Lavender Essential Oil, and it says for all skin types. So I've really been loving this. I like how watery this is. It kind of reminds me of the texture of the Shiseido cleansing oil, which I'm completely out of. I don't have any more. That's another really good one. But this is so nice. I like using this one, like it says, midnight at night, like late at night, because the lavender oil just relaxes me, and it's so calming when you're doing the annoying task of taking your makeup off. This just makes it less annoying because it's relaxing. So I like that there's lavender oil in it, and it has a ton of other like essential oils in it that are really good for your skin. So I like making the makeup removal process something that's still good for my skin, because when you're using makeup wipes, you're just wiping and wiping. And a lot of makeup wipes also have like a lot of preservatives in them to keep them like wet. So I just try to like use makeup wipes like every now and then, and I'll just always go for a cleansing oil.
I feel like I use them more out of town than at home.
Yeah, at home I always go for cleansing oils. Like makeup wipes to me, I use it when I really don't have a choice, when I just need something convenient and quick. But I don't know, I feel like cleansing oils are just as quick because you just rinse it off and go into your regular cleansing. So this Kiehl's one is bomb. A OG favorite of mine is this Dermalogica Pre-Cleanse. I have like 2 bottles of this. So one I bought myself and the other they sent to me, and I'm so glad because I'm obsessed with this stuff. This is like one of my all-time favorite cleansing oils because it literally melts your makeup so freaking fast. And I like the pump. One pump, so much comes out. Like, you don't need to be pumping forever because one pump, a lot comes out. So I like that about the pump. And I also like the way this smells as well. I'm not sure what's in here.
That one actually smells like lavender to me.
I smell the lavender, it's but like I smell something, some other kind of oil in here. Smell. Oh, it has apricot oil in here as well. Interesting. But this is just so, so nice. Once again, it has a really relaxing, calming scent. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't break me out. Like, neither one of these break me out because I feel like anything breaks me out these days. But these do not. And they're very gentle on the skin. So Dermalogica is one of my favorite skincare brands. Like, if you don't know like what to try, your skin is super sensitive, I feel like Dermalogica is a really good one to go to. And this pre-cleanse is the absolute truth. Been using it for years, hasn't steered me wrong. And then the last skincare product that I'm going to recommend, you guys, this was really hard because I have so many serums, oils, face oils. I have a lot of skincare, okay? So it's kind of hard to narrow it down. But this is something that I've been talking about since last year. I was looking for a vitamin C that wouldn't irritate my skin because I noticed with some vitamin C, like oils or serums, I get like a rash on my face with like little white bumps. So I think my skin might be vitamin C sensitive. So I have to like use either medical grade vitamin C or like something that's like more natural. Of course, is one of their clean brands at Sephora, which I really like. This is their 15% vitamin C serum. I don't know why they call this a serum because it's more like an oil. Mm-hmm. And I hate when people like name oil serums because I feel like a serum is not an oil. There's two different things to me. But this is still a really good product. I only use vitamin C in the morning because at night I'm using like acids and retinol or something like that. So I feel like vitamin C's are meant for morning time because it helps, you know, protect your skin and it helps with dark spots and it also helps you look more glowy. So this is just one of my favorite ones. I think this is like my 3rd bottle of this stuff. I do go through it kind of fast. You do have to shake it up when you use it because it has 2 different like formulas in here that work together. So you have to shake it up and it's like this pink color. And also
kind of like micellar water. It kind of reminds me of that.
Yeah, it looks kind of like the texture of it. Mm-hmm. It feels watery, but honestly, if you put too much on your face, you will be greasy throughout the day.
It turns into like oil.
So I recommend shaking it up. Make sure you shake it, like I said, and doing 2 to 3 drops. Because if you do any more than that, then this will leave you greasy, which is kind of annoying. But the reason I really like using this one and go back to this one is because it helps fade my dark spots faster without irritating my skin. Because I have used some things that do like fade my dark spots like really fast, but they give me a rash. And to me, it's not worth walking around with my face itching and just feeling raw. I don't like that feeling. So this is very comfortable on my sensitive skin. But once again, if you're oily, use 1 to 2 drops, maybe 3, because it gets kind of oily, but I really like it. So this is a vitamin C I'll stick with for a while. Eventually I might like try a medical grade one because like medical grade products don't really irritate my skin as much. But, like a lot of other vitamin C's on Sephora don't really do much for me.
Nothing.
Like it's literally like putting nothing on my face. It's just like a wasted step. Mm-hmm. And anything I put on my face, I want it to be effective. Mm-hmm. So this is a vitamin C that's non-irritating but still effective that's on Sephora. Because if you want some more intense, you might want to go for medical grade.
Yeah, which I prefer. Okay, so last but not least, we both have a perfume to mention because I feel like it's not like appropriate not to buy a perfume during the sale because perfumes are kind of pricey and you might as well get your 15 to 20% off.
Yeah.
Why not? Mm-hmm. So I always get a perfume, whether it's something that I ran out of that I already have or if it's something that I'm trying that I've never tried before that I probably had samples of. So it's the perfect opportunity to get a perfume. This one I want to mention because I mentioned it last year and I repurchased another one during this sale.
I'm sure you did.
This is like one of my all-time favorite spring and summer scents. This is from the brand Hermes. This, I cannot pronounce the name, the actual name of this actual scent. This is the Un Jardin e Mediterranean.
It's the Mediterranean scent.
Yeah. So this one I'm obsessed with. It's like the perfect, like fresh summer scent. Like this smells like the Amalfi Coast, although I've never been yet. I'm gonna go eventually, and I feel like this is what I'll bring on that vacation.
This does smell like that.
It's just like so fresh and clean. Mm-hmm. It has like a hint of a fruity smell, but it's like in the citrus kind of family.
Yeah.
Like if you like clean scents, if you're into like a Tory Burch or Acqua di Gioia from Giorgio Armani, or if you like Light Blue by Dolce & Gabbana, this is in that family. But this is like unlike anything I've ever smelled. It's very unique. It has almost like a minty kind of smell as well.
I smell the mint in it too. That's what makes it fresh.
Yeah. Like when you breathe it in, you know how some perfumes you'd be like, strong? But when you breathe this in, it's almost like aromatherapy.
That smells like the beach, but better.
Yes. But it doesn't have like that coconutty beach smell.
No.
It has like that fresh beach smell. Like almost like a sea salt.
Yes. That's what I'm trying to get. Like sea salty, oceany, with
this
mint.
This is a vacation.
Like if the ocean smelled like peppermints or like
mixed with sea salt.
I don't know. It's hard to describe, but it's very fresh. Very fresh and clean.
I love this.
It's perfect for summer because I feel like when you use like winter scents in summer, they don't really mix well with sweat
because they're like extremely like warm and woodsy and like have like a lot of like a sweetness to them.
Yeah,
that's true.
But I feel like that keeps you smelling fresh,
and
even
clean.
If you sweat a little bit.
Like I remember last summer when we went to Turks and Caicos, every time the wind would blow,
Chelsea
would smell this on me.
It's
so good.
It's light but strong at the same time.
Yes, that's because I spray a lot because it's a very light scent
and you want it to last.
Yes, it's not one of those heavy perfumes. It's very light, so you have to spray more on to get it to last, but I don't mind because I kind of use it like a body spray instead of a perfume because I spray it everywhere. I'm obsessed. So if you guys have not tried this one, I highly recommend it. So good.
And then the scent that I'm going to mention is something that I mentioned in our yearly favorites, and it's like my cult scent of 2018, but I'm still using it now in 2019.
It's very sweet.
Like I always go for it. It's not very sweet. And it is the Chloe Nomad perfume. And I've said it before, but I'll say it again. This is one of my favorite scents that I own. And it's just a really universal scent. I feel like you would like this if you like fresh scents or sweet scents. I feel like this is a combination of all of those. It's like a hybrid of scents into one perfume. It's not too much of one thing, because some perfumes are just like too much of one thing. You're like, okay, that's too much. Because I easily get a headache with a lot of perfumes. That's why I don't buy a lot of perfumes like Kendra does, because I'm very, I don't know, sensitive when it comes to scents. Like I get a headache so easy.
Your skin is sensitive, her nose sensitive.
Everything on me is sensitive except my feelings. Like I don't, but everything else is like very sensitive.
Yeah.
Yeah, most scents give me a headache, but this is so like soft with like a sweet but a fresh. It's just like, it's very hard to describe. You have to smell it. If you're ordering online, I recommend like getting like a mini size, but I buy the mini size like anyway just to keep in my purse, just because I like it on the go as well. It's just so good. It has like a, like I said, a fresh sweet scent, so it's like a combination, kind of like fruity. It has a little bit of fruity in there, so that's why
it's
this
sweet. I don't smell fruit.
You don't smell fruit in that?
I smell just a hint, just a little bit.
But that's why I said it's a hybrid of scents.
But it's mostly sweet.
You can pick up a lot of different things from this, depending on what your nose
and body chemistry. It might smell different on different people.
That's very true. Mm-hmm. This is the perfect year-round scent, and I'm obsessed with it. So yeah, love this. I might have to do an updated like perfumes video because that's more Kendra's territory. So if you're
not, you like perfume too.
If you're like me and you're sensitive to scents and a lot of them give you headaches,
you just stick to like certain ones.
Yes.
I can't stick to like, I don't have a signature scent.
Exactly. She likes a lot of different kinds. I feel like I'm very particular. And if you guys want me to do a video talking about perfumes that don't give me a headache that I love, then I would do that for you guys because everything gives me a headache. So yeah.
Okay guys, so that completes our Sephora VIB sale recommendations. The sale is still currently going on. I think it's over like what, May 6th.
Yeah.
So you have pretty much an entire week to shop. So let us know what you're going to be getting. Let us know if you already have tried these products before and you're going to repurchase them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let us know what you're going to get. Or let us know in the comments what you usually buy during these kind of sales, because we're big on skincare and perfume, like, because it's so expensive and it's like the best things to buy during this kind of sale, like the stuff that you wouldn't normally get.
And we have like a handful of makeup
yes
products.
And as far as mine and Kelsey's actual VIB sale haul, we're going to be getting our stuff sometime toward the end of this week. So we will be filming the haul next week, like the beginning of next week. So be looking out for that because it's going to be probably pretty big, large haul like always, because it's two of us and we both get a pretty good amount of stuff. So be looking out for that. And yeah, we love you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you guys in the next one.